you have any questions about the college, see them. But I'm here only to welcome you and glad that we can have this event. And Colin Charlotte Smith, do want to recognize Don Maynard, who's put a lot of work for the Chamber, Elizabethtown White Lake Chamber of Commerce, for this event. Thank you very much. Ms. Charlotte Smith, who's also a trustee of the college, recognize you as well. Ms. Smith.
Thank you, Dr. Finn. Welcome, you guys, to our first Candidates Forum. I'm Charlotte Smith with Bladen Online. This event is sponsored by the Elizabethtown White Lake Area Chamber of Commerce, which is a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization. Our goal tonight is to educate the voting public about our county candidates and our county issues. So I'd like to take a moment to thank Dr. Finn and Bladen Community College for allowing us to host this event at their facility. Thank you. If you'll please stand, we'll say the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. The candidates you'll hear from tonight will be asked questions completely randomly. They'll have 3 minutes to answer the questions. There will not be any follow-up questions, and there will be no debate between the candidates. The audience is asked to remain quiet during this, and then at the end of each round, we will allow for applause. Our first group is the Bladen County Board of Education in District 3. If Ms. Bonnell Walker and Mr. Chris Clark could come up. You have a seat there. After I ask the question, I will then time. There'll be a buzzer. Once that goes off, that time is up. So we'll begin with Mr. Clark. Can you give us your opening statement, please?
My name is Christopher Clark.
I know a few of you in the room, and I have to say, I know one of them is a teacher, but I tell you how young I am, how old maybe one of them is. So, my name is Christopher Clark. I'm 42 years old. I'm born here in Bladen County, raised in Bladen County. A lot of you know my family history. I'm here running for Board of Education District 3 because there needs to be some changes. And we've seen it flat out, face first, in our little battle we've been having with one of our children. I have a wife, Tim Clark, and two boys, Hunter, which is 15, and Cody, which is 9.
Okay. All right, the next question then would be, Mr. Clark, do you think any schools in Bladen County need to be closed?
Well, we don't need to close any schools, but I think there's a lot of variables you have to look at. I don't personally see where one town or two towns should lose every school they have. If you're going to consolidate the school, if it's just come to the point, then I can't change the past, what's happened in the past. But if it's come down to the point where the Board of Education has to do something, we just have to do something. But personally, I think there's other ways around closing two schools in one town, two towns. I don't see why you can't, if it's come to shove, you can't consolidate. Let's just throw Carter School of Discovery and Booker T. Washington, for example. Not one family, but why can't you put those two schools together? The town doesn't lose a school. All right, we're going to consolidate the schools. That's the idea. Right, so then we're going to consolidate the schools, but they're going to push all these other children where these teachers are going to go. Teachers are probably going to start losing jobs. If anybody's going to be cut, it needs to be somebody higher up. You don't need to cut the teachers out. And then you're going to move this school and this old school itself is already an old school. So what's going to happen in the next 5 to 10 years is it's going to start sucking dry. Repairs. It's already been stated that one is in some dire need of electrical upgrades, the other one's mechanical upgrades. So why can't you consolidate those two schools, start working on a new school in the future to replace the one that had been consolidated to? Nothing lasts forever. Something might have to be replaced. You just can't keep closing and closing. Then you're going to start looking at shoving children in bigger class size. You're going to get less attention. Teachers are going to be able to give less attention to the children. Children are not going to get the attention they need. So, like I say, personally, I don't see any school closing. But, like I said, a lot of variables in it. You know, if they have to, we have to. But I still say, if you close or consolidate those two, you know, at least the town doesn't lose everything.
Thank you. The next question, Mr. Clark, is: do you think children with special needs are receiving what they need from our public schools to be successful in the classroom?
No, ma'am, no. And personally, it's a really touchy issue with me because if you had been in my shoes and traveled down the road that I traveled down, my wife traveled down, or our family traveled down, in the last 2 years of my son, you would flat out see how the special need for exceptional children works in Bladen County. It needs drastic improvement. The Board of Education, or not the Board of the District, just for instance, let me give an example. I just like to give examples. The therapist has to give the children the things they need to operate. We've seen it personally because our son had received it. So I don't know why that is, but you know, that needs to change. Also, you're talking about children with special needs. Okay, there's a whole wide range of that. So you can't really narrow that on, okay, special needs children needs one certain microphone. It doesn't work like that. One child may need a bigger microphone. One child may need a little swim microphone. Whatever it is they need that can help them get through their school day and learn. I think there needs to be some more attention to that issue. I really do.
Okay. Last question, Mr. Clark. Do you think Bladen County Schools is receiving the funding that is needed at the level that it's needed from Bladen County?
Well, I guess that's a touchy situation. But everybody says no, somebody says yes. I really can't answer that question truthfully because I do not know what their budget is. I do not know what the county's situation is as far as financing, what their finances are. I do know that they are given a right good bit of money, but truthfully, I would have to look into more into that because, like I say, I have not given enough time to research that when they're all total. So, I would hope that they are. And also, I think in terms of the Board of Education needs to talk to them a little bit. You know, if it's like every family, time to get tight and start cutting the slack a little bit. Nickel and dime here, next dollar down the road.
Okay. Thank you very much for your time and for coming out and participating in our candidates forum. So we'll give them applause. Our executive director is helping us out, getting ready for our next group of candidates. If you would like to ask the candidates questions, they are here. so we're not going to make it a question and answer, a Q&A. We're not going to have that part, but afterwards, if you would like to talk with a candidate, I'm sure that's what they're here for. Our next group of candidates here tonight is District 3 County Commissioner candidates, Ms. Ashley Trivett and Mr. Kenneth Register.
Natural gas, our location and distance from the interstate. There's
those are all huge factors that people don't look at and say, hey, I want to start a business here in Bladen. But I would like to look at it and say, hey, what do we have to offer? And see what we can attract those businesses for what we do have. Shine a positive light on our beautiful county, because we do have a lot to offer. And I'm proud of what we've accomplished so far, and I know we're just going to move forward. All right, Ms. Trivett, do you think Bladen County is providing the level of funding that schools, the Bladen County schools need?
You know, I haven't seen their budget. I don't know what they're receiving each year or each month. I don't know what their operating costs are. It would appear that they're not, just because I know as a citizen, as a stepmom of two daughters who have come out of Bladen County School, there are needs. I think there's always going to be needs in our school system, because there's just never enough money that you can give to them. They always deserve more. And yet, at the same time, having to operate on a budget. And I feel like that's something we've got to just really focus on and encourage those officials and candidates who are elected this election to, you know, reach out to them, talk with them, and let them know their concerns. For me personally, you know, I feel like there's always more that can be done. I would love to see our school systems thrive. And I know that we can definitely have the individuals who love our children, our teachers who are more than qualified and want the same thing for our students just as we do. Every parent that moves into our county, they're going to look for our school systems and see how we do on our test. And if we're going to grow our economy and grow our county and improve, we've got to have a stronger education system. And we've got to always have a stronger education system. There's never a line that we're going to meet and say, okay, we're there, check. You've got to always improve. Everything is changing and everything evolves. Like technology, every 3 months there's a new phone that's out. And that's the same thing with education. There's so many ways that you can approach education and learning tools to help all students who don't learn the same way. And I just feel like whatever budget the school system has to operate on, and make sure that we're funding those programs, those jobs, those whatever, buildings, schools, closing or staying open. The main thing is the children. If we just keep that in mind, I think we'll be in the right direction. Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to come out and join us for this forum. Let's give her an applause. Our final group are the county at-large candidates for commissioners. Jimmy Smith. Mr. Jimmy Smith could not be here. He said that he had a health issue come up that he couldn't prevent, so he sent his apologies. Mr. Michael Cogdell, Mr. Ray Britt, Mr. David Gooden, Mr. Randolph Crow, and Ms. Pam Benton. If you'll come up and join us where your nameplate is.
Leadership, hands-on, and I give him all the praise for my success to survive in such an economy that we have had for the last several years, to start a business with no backing and to withstand the economy that we have had over the years and to still maintain, I say it's been tough. Being said that, after living in Myrtle Beach, Panama City, Florida, Bladen County's home, and I look forward to coming back home. And I'm proud to have a business here. I'm proud to have served on Dr. Fenn's business board here in college, economical board in Elizabethtown for the city. I've had the opportunity to be United Way chairman. I've been the Optimist president 5 times out of 20 years. I've been on as many as 4 advisory boards for our county schools in the same year. It's been a pleasure to do all of that. I've had the opportunity to coach minor major in Dixie ball. But getting to our government, I feel that we have a long way to go. As far as a rural county, I think a lot of people look at us and they're jealous in some degree. We may find fault sometime, but it's tough out there and it's been tough in a lot of areas. But I see there is room for growth. I promise, as hard as I work, to maintain a business with my wife and I 37 years, and she's my business partner and my friend. And it gives me great pleasure to work with her every day in Bladen County. I look forward to taking the opportunity, and if given to me, to be your county commissioner, to be the people's choice. And I close with this statement in my opening statement. I think we all need to go back and learn the first song we learned when we went to church. Red, yellow, black, and white, we're all precious in His sight. And come together and work together, and we'll stay together, and we'll grow together if we work hard and be determined and set standards and make sure that our people excel and we will achieve this. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mr. Gooden, will you please give us your opening statement?
Okay. For opening statement, my family consists of my wife, Pat, 3 children, Chris, Jason, and Channing, and 7 grandchildren. And for the first 29 years of my employment, I taught agricultural education in high school. 25 of those years were spent at East Bladen. Presently, our family is involved in a farming operation. We're involved in swine, turkey, beef cattle, hay operation, and produce. That's where you get the good strawberries. The other interests I have, I am president of the Bladen County Livestock Association. And I'm on the board of directors for Cape Fear Farm Credit. And what my campaign is all about is keeping your taxes low, wisely spending your money, and put the farmer on the board of commissioners. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Crow. Please give us your opening statement.
I sure will.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for this invitation. My name is Randy Crow. I was born in Houston, Texas, February 12, 1946. My father was born in Wilmington in 1910, bought a home in Kelly, March 2005. Since March 23rd of this year, I've lost as many pounds as my age. Yes, it's more than 39. Kelly side of the river has never had a county commissioner, so that means Kelly Cummings never have to pay taxes? Okay, I am a Christian, concerned citizen, patriot, swear to protect and defend the United States Constitution, conservative, believe the county sheriff is the highest law of the land, the county commissioner's powers above the state and federal government, believe education up to the county. Common Core must be anonymous or kids' brains become the problem in the state. I love research, keeping track of money and projects. I've worked in small businesses all my life. At age 21, I started working for Proflex Sales Corporation, supervising its 6 service stations, living in Huntsville, Texas, attending Sam Houston State University, where I earned a Bachelor of Business Administration degree. Became branch manager, vice president, director of ProFlight, signed on all checking accounts. My business life has been creating value for real estate, making sure money gets to the bank. Employed Houston's first black service station supervisor. First service station to sell beer. We had 8 Hispanic stations, one of our company's largest. Took service station manager to see Muhammad Ali at the Astrodome in 1971. Gave a pumpkin or a pound of sausage with a fill-up on Halloween. Project manager to remove 50 or so gasoline tanks. Helped sell all the real estate. Company bought the largest percent of a $2 billion bank. ProFlight owned and operated 35 gas stations, owned a 6,900-acre ranch near Oakwood, Texas. Purchased from the original partners. I was involved from day one with ProFlight and ProRanch until 1994. I've been a real estate broker for 40 years, owned and operated a high-tech sewage treatment plant in Caroline, Texas. 1986, contracted out our family dream home, 2119 Rochester Place in Wilmington. 2 sons, both have college degrees, 1 UNC, Chapel Hill, the other SMU, both in the real estate business in Raleigh. Presently, I am a small investor. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Britt, do you think the Blaine County tax rate is too high, too low, just right? And what will you do to affect the rate?
Well, personally, I think it's too high. However, that comes with a statement. When you compare it to 6 surrounding counties, and if you compare it to the counties of similarity, we're right in pretty much line from 80 to 82, 81, 83%. Then when you get people like Wilmington, New Hanover County, where they got a broad base of high real estate on the coast, obviously pay more taxes so you can spread it more. But I think if we go back to my opening statement, to lower it, the tax base, which I think that's all of us' dream and hopes would be, if we go back as a commissioner, I pledge that I think we all need to be held accountable. We need to work harder with our industrial commission. We need to set standards, requirements. We need to be willing to travel and travel as much as need be. We need to lean on the government, the Congress, the Senate, everyone that leans on us every 4 years for their vote. They know the people, they know the companies, and they know the organizations. I think we need to apply all the pressure we can and court them as much as we can and lean on our peers in our community that have also association with these same people and unite together as commissioners with the strong business force in our entire county. Get people from every aspect of the county that knows these people, that have the opportunity to meet the people and know the people that have businesses to offer to entice them to come to our area. And then we need to be competitive. What can we give and what do we have to offer? And we have to make that available and be willing to work hard to see that can be accomplished. And then I think you can see your tax rate come down some. And then you know you got other angles to look at on the tax rate. You got some people that choose not to own a home, but they could be a millionaire. So they're not paying the taxes in the system. So we probably need to look at that at some point in time. I always encourage that because you know, you got somebody sitting there in the school system and he's wealthy and doesn't want to take care of a house or any of the projects around the home and choose to live in an apartment, then he's exempt of some of the taxes right there. And so I think there's a lot of things to look at. But personally, yes, I think they're high, but under the circumstances to redo the other, I don't see much of a change. We can go in and look harder personally at where our dollars are now being spent. That would be one of the things. I have some personal issues that I want to look at. And believe me, I'm a person that asks questions. Officer won't ask. And you won't hear me shut up till I get it. And I promise if you ask me, I'm going to get you to answer. And it may come with a lot of adversity, because I've had to go up against the state for 17 years on the Board of Elections. There's a lot of things in the election law that I don't like.
Thank you, Mr. Britt. I appreciate that.
Thanks so much.
Mr. Gooden. Let me reset this first, so you don't run out of time. All right. Mr. Gooden, do you think the tax rate in Bladen County is too high, too low, or just right? And what will you do to affect that rate?
Well, I think the tax rate in Bladen County is a little bit high. And as I have said before, you know, we need to give taxpayers a break. And my goal is to keep tax rates down. Spend those tax dollars wisely.
Thank you. Mr. Crow. Do you think Bladen County tax rate is too high, too low, just right? And what will you do to affect the rate?
I didn't really know how this was going to work. I put some things together and we'll try to see how this works, but anyway, we'll see. Basically, I'm happy with the property taxes I pay Bladen County, and it seems county government paid costs are reasonable. I love farms, blueberry, grape, corn, cotton, horse, timber, hog, turkey, and their tax rate exemption must be kept and or increased. Our farming lifestyle must be protected with tax exemptions. Own a horse, we get property tax exemption. Raise, sell vegetables, property tax exemption. Economic development must be environmental friendly. No new industry which draws down the water table, pollutes water, or pollutes in any manner, or adds to our traffic problems. As a real estate professional, I have watched in horror the destruction of quality of life in the name of economic growth in Houston, Paraland, and Wilmington. Cities once like E-Town and Cherish Farm Lake, most developers tell how much tax dollars the county would get if this apartment complex or that bunch of postage stamp subdivisions are approved. Left out of the conversation is the real cost, providing police, fire protection, and schools versus tax income. In many cases, apartments pay $500 per year per unit taxes where two to three kids and parents live in them. The cost for services provided the entire family may amount to $5,000 per year or more. The town always arrives when property values fall. A guy bought a nearly new double wide in Kelly this year on the tax rolls for $80,000 and paid $54,000. Economic development should not trigger tax increases on existing taxpayers. In my opinion, economic development must improve the quality of life of all Bladen County residents. County government was not intended to push through development for outsiders to benefit state or federal government or monopolists and corporations financially, with the county taxpayer footing the bill. Notice the detention center is financed for 40 years. Hope no slick banksters are allowed in with their financial scams like interest rate swaps. Every day the loan is prepaid is a great day. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Gooden, are you satisfied with the level of economic growth in our county?
Bladen County has some good things going on, and we need to be sure that we keep what we have. And what Bladen County needs to do is be competitive with the other counties in southeastern North Carolina when it comes to putting together the Senate packages. One thing for a fact, Bladen County has a lot of miles of railroad track that is not being utilized by industry.
Thank you. Mr. Crowe, are you satisfied with the level of economic growth in our county?
Well, I'm not a real big, well, you know, there's a lot of different types of growth, and I see a little bit of growth in Kelly area, and but not too much, but it seems to be fine. I like being in a floodplain where there's not too many things going on. But I don't know, the traffic in Keytown sometimes bothers me on Friday afternoon. But it's really kind of hard to tell about the growth. I don't really see farms growing. I think farms have been less of them. And I really hope that an agricultural economy is to be respected because there's so few of them. Lived in Houston, and Wilmington, Houston was a beautiful farm, I mean, not ranching community, and now it's horrible. It goes out 50 miles with houses on top of each other. So I think, I really don't know. It seems to be growing to me, and so far it's not horrible, but I really don't know. I don't want it to grow any faster than it's growing. And I wish it would add some more farms and things like that, cattle, horses. I guess that's it.
Okay. Thank you. Mr. Britt, are you satisfied with the level of economic growth in our county?
I thought it was not a fair question to ask somebody in business. I don't know if satisfaction is ever enough when you're in business, but not related to me, but when you look at families that, we all love our kids, but when your kids grow up and they go to school, you have to lose them. So many of them don't have anything to come back here for. And personally, I'm not satisfied for that reason. I have a son right now waiting to go to dental school, and I'm proud to know that he has chosen to want to come back to Elizabethtown and practice dentistry once he gets in. We have three people that can retire any moment. But, and to have a young person of that stature today that wants to come back home, I'm proud to say that he's mine. And got a fine young girlfriend that graduates this year in pharmacy, and she's coming back home to be a pharmacist. But to go back to a few things, we have a strong business department here at BCC. And there's a lot of opportunity there as far as industry coming in. I've heard so many times where we don't have skilled labor. Well, I can go back and a lot of people can show you here. We've had a lot of factories in the past that require skilled labor. And there's a statement that you hear a lot of times, if you build, they will come. Or if you build, they will come back. We have lost a lot of skilled labor and people qualified to do skilled labor that's had to choose to go elsewhere to seek employment. I would like for us to work hard in these companies that doesn't have the people that's qualified that maybe they need. Through the business department here, Dr. Fenn will tell you, and if our business head was here, he may be in, I may not see him. There's a lot of opportunity right here at this college through funding and all that is willing to train and teach, and that's available and it's out there. I'm not satisfied, and it goes back to my opening statement, and based on taxation, I think we need to work harder, we need to get a game plan, we need to get a group together with the commissioners, and you need to meet regularly and see what the progress is, continue to work hard and push forward for our people to grow our county. If you grow this county, your tax base can come down, and that's as simple as that. I mean, somebody's got to pay. And the only way you can get it down is spread it, and that's with more people making more money, and then you can drop the rate.
Thank you. Mr. Britt, do you think Bladen County is providing the level of funding that Bladen County schools that is needed?
There again, this is a tough one to ask me, and I'm going to just tell you straight up the way I feel. When I went to school, my best friend was an astronaut, so we had doctors, we had dentists, we had lawyers, we all did work. Our superintendent's office had 7 people working in it, and we all did well. Big government gets expensive. Teachers are paid terribly. We need to go back and relook at the dollars that we are spending now in our educational system and see why it takes so much to run the administrative office with so many people and so many assistants and positions. And I say that with all due respect, because I got a lot of friends, and this is not to make anybody ill, but it's all about the dollar. That's what we're discussing tonight. And until we go back and address, when you've been on an advisory board 4 times in 4 different schools, I know what those teachers are doing. I know what they're pulling out of their own pocket to buy supplies. So are we giving them enough? Not when it gets to the teacher. But if we got to support that administrative office staff out there, then the teacher and her pupils and students are not being treated fairly and equally. And that goes right back to Mr. Clark's statement. We need to look at what we're supposed to be doing. I know some of the hardships he's faced, and those positions should have already been taken care of. When he's had to cross those hurdles, guess what? It had to be done, or it should have been done. But the funding's got to come. But it goes right back to what we said. We got to go back and sit down. When I do my books, I have to sit down and do a line item description on every dollar I spend. And I might be the least educated sitting at any of these tables. And Dr. Fentz heard me say that many times. And boards that I'm on, he's on economic board with me in downtown. But he'll tell you, I'll tell it like it is. And we need to look at it and go back and rethink it and put it on the table and just say, hey, this has got to go. You know, and just man up to it. And I'm sorry to be blatant and bold, but that's what we need. And I promise you, that's me. And what you see is what you're going to get, and you're going to hear it. And that's just the way it is. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Crow, do you think Bladen County is providing the level of funding that Bladen County schools need?
Well, I did some research on this because I thought we were going to have a forum on education about a month ago, and it was canceled. And I've kind of forgotten what I researched. But I did research. I mean, I went around to all the schools. I checked the College Board SAT scores and the cost of education. I don't know if this will be well received, but I did notice that of the counties in our area, we were spending the least amount of money on education per student, on a per student basis. Bladen County is a very, to me, it's an unusual place because it's so daggone big, and the kids are going to have to go a long ways to get to school. But I was impressed with the way the schools looked, but I was very discouraged looking through all the things that the teachers have to do. I mean, good gracious, they all have to have an assistant just to make sure that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. I mean, the federal government and the state have just gotten in here, and I think they ought to send them all away. I mean, they're just driving everybody crazy. But I mean, just to play sports and everything else, all the things you got to do, I just don't see how anything can get done with all the things. But as far as paying enough to the teachers for the mess that I think you have to go through, I don't know if there's enough money to pay them. But anyway, I don't know. This county, but the school system in the United States got me very upset. And I read a book on Common Core that upset me. I mean, when you put stuff on the cloud and you put all these test scores on people's names, they're keeping all track of everything that these kids have in their brain from day one. And that's wrong. It ought to be anonymous because they can use that in the way they're teaching and phrases and everything. There are just a lot of problems as far as I'm concerned with the school system in general. But I'll shut up now. I really don't know what I'm talking about. But just a little bit of thread about it is just upsetting. But to answer your question, I don't know. So I don't know if you're getting enough or not.
Thank you. Mr. Gooden, I'll ask you the same question. Do you think Bladen County is providing the level of funding Bladen County schools needs?
I think the current level of funding is probably fine, but where my real fault goes is with administration. I worked in Bladen County for 25 years. Believe me, it is top heavy.
That's all the questions we have for these candidates. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you all very much. I would ask the candidates, if you will, stick around. We have some questions that some citizens would like to ask. Also, I'd like to have Ms. Dawn Maynard, Executive Director of the Chamber, come up and close us out. Thank you.
I really wanted to come up here to take the opportunity to thank Charlotte for doing such a stellar job at the podium. I think she deserves it. Easy position to be up here and asking these questions, and she was calm and collected and did a very good job. I also want to thank my board of directors. I have an excellent board that supports everything that we do and try to do in this community, and a special thanks and shout out to Robin Summerlin, because he actually really helped in the front hand of all of this coordination of this event tonight. I was kind of nervous about it, so I'm going to reinstate that we are a non-partisan, non-profit organization just trying to do good stuff in the community, just like the efforts of all the candidates, which is the folks I want to thank most importantly for your time tonight. I was hoping to have a few of the others attend, and I know that there's a lot of things going on. I know that there's some roads that are keeping people from driving, you know, here the quickest way as possible. I know that was some of the reasons that a few people couldn't come. The others I'm not sure of, but I hope that if there are other forums between now and the election day, that the community will come out and support those efforts of the people that put them together. I'm not aware of any other ones, but someone might put something together. It's hard times right now, very sad. Our county's going through, you know, so much from Hurricane Matthew. I wanted to make a few announcements so that if you have the opportunity to give your time, your money to the United Way and the Bladen Crisis Center, they're in much need of simple things: cleaning supplies, Windex, paper towels, bleach, stuff like that, toiletry items. There's folks that they haven't bathed in days, and it takes a lot of time in between getting the new bar of soap and washcloth, towels, items like that, and of course food. A lot of food is in need. Thursday, that's 2 days from now, if you own a truck and you have a little bit of time Thursday morning, Ms. Kathy Page, who takes care of our local Bladen Crisis Center, they moved, when we started getting an abundance of donations, they moved them over to the community center located behind the Elizabethtown Town Hall. Well, just as most all of the candidates at one point or another stated that, you know, we need to unite, we need to work together, and that's exactly what these organizations are doing, such as the United Way and the Bladen Crisis Center, the Men's Baptist Association. They're putting everything at the industrial park, which is where the United Way currently is now. There's a building out there, there's a lot of stuff around, a lot of organization that needs to be put in place so these folks can go shopping you get what they need, uniform, school, whatever tuck that you want to take over there, they certainly won't turn it away. At this time, again, thank my board members that are here tonight and just all of you for coming, and I hope that you have a safe trip home.